Surveillance video shows what happened minutes after the Tropicana Casino kicked Connor Castellani out for being underage. The 20-year-old is surrounded by at least five Atlantic City police officers in the early morning hours of June 15th, his hands behind his back. Then he empties his pockets. Minutes later, he walks away. It all seems fairly routine. Then the situation escalates. Castellani crosses the street, yelling at police. 1 minute later, still yelling, officers still holding back. Then approximately 1 minute, 40 seconds into it, police have had enough. It takes four officers to wrestle him to the ground. For the next 45 seconds, they knee and strike Castellani with batons as they try to handcuff him. A fifth officer arrives. This is how Castellani remembers it.
I was just basically rolling up in a ball. I said I wasn't resisting. I told them that, and they just continued to beat me. And during it, I was just basically holding on for life.
You can see at this point on the tape, the officers have managed to get Castellani on his stomach, one hand almost behind his back. 5 seconds later, a canine officer pulls up, jumps out of his car, and immediately sets his dog on Castellani.
When the dog actually chomped down the back of my neck, I was also receiving blows to the back of my head with a fist.
Police arrested Castellani, charging him with resisting arrest, disorderly conduct, and aggravated assault on an officer and a canine. Hospital pictures show he needed 200 stitches to close his wounds and multiple dog bites on his head and neck.
I walked into the room and he was shackled to the bed by his feet. He looked like he was in shock. He was bleeding and oozing everywhere.
To see the shock in his eyes was devastating. It was the worst thing a parent could possibly, experience.
Then Castellani's parents saw the surveillance tape of what happened.
I was just numb. I actually went home and got sick. It was really, really terrible. You don't want to see anybody that happened to anyone, but especially your own child.
I could see no justification. It was a scene out of like a bad movie.
The Castellanis are suing the Atlantic City Police Department as well as the city. They want charges against their son dropped and the officers disciplined.
I think it is one of the most egregious examples of excessive force, police brutality that I have ever seen. You can't just bum rush a kid who has said something offensive to you. It's not okay. It's an abuse of your police authority.
The Castellanis point to court records, which show the canine officer involved had 15 prior complaints related to excessive force or assault. He was exonerated in all those cases. That officer, Sterling Wheaton, still has five additional suits pending against him. The Atlantic City Police would not make Wheaton or any of the officers involved in the Castellani case available. But the chief of the department says it's too early for judgment.
All I can tell you is that there's an internal investigation and that when it's over, I'll be able to speak about the results.
At this point, though, you were standing by the officers.
Oh, absolutely. And at the conclusion of the investigation, then we'll move forward from there.
The mayor of Atlantic City called the video disturbing and has asked the state's attorney general to oversee that investigation. We showed the tape to former police officer and law enforcement expert Lou Palumbo.
He comes out.
He's not handcuffed.
And he immediately releases the dog.
Can I tell you, you're in a little bit of a gray area. Perceptively, it's terrible.
Do you believe the amount of force that was used was appropriate?
I have to say that the amount of force that I believe they used here was appropriate, yes.
John Chain, professor at John Jay College of Criminal Justice, says from his perspective, the use of the dog was an unnecessary and potentially deadly use of force.
I don't know of any training that allows police officers to launch the dog onto somebody's neck, which is right where the dog went, which could have killed him very easily.
Do you believe there could be any justification for the officer's actions that night?
No.
None whatsoever.
None.
Castellani showed me the scars he will now have to live with, but he says his experience has not shaken his trust in law enforcement.
I'm not saying all cops are bad. Like, majority of them are good people who are here to protect us, but there's just some that I guess have to be looked out for.
Jason Carroll, CNN, Atlantic City, New Jersey.